Hi students, so we are back with the programming. So now this third program is called as bubble sort, and this is also a part of third module, and also you are going to get in this lab program number 10. Okay, so now what is this sorting? Okay, so before we start, as usual, take a book and pen, write up the program one so that you can easily understand the tracing. Okay, sorting is nothing but you are going to arrange the whatever the data is there either in the ascending order or descending order. In general, we will go with ascending order. Only if you change one simple logic, it will be arranged in the descending order. Okay, so we have many types of sorts, such as heap sort, quick sort, merge sort, selection sort, bubble sort. Okay, so in your syllabus you have two types of sorting, that is bubble sort and selection sort. Okay, so first thing is bubble sort. So here I am taking the array name as A and array size is 5. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, why it is until 4? Because array starts at 0 and ends at n minus 1. Here it starts at 0. What is the n size? 5. 5 minus 1 is 4. So 0 to 4, it has got ended. Okay, so here after I arrange these elements, the element should be in the order 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Okay, so because since we are arranging in the ascending order, we are going from smaller to the bigger number. Okay, now you can see here the same example have been explained. So here what happens basically is, in general, first you are going to find the smallest, or the sorry not the smallest you are going to first find the largest element in the array, and you are going to put it at the last one. Okay, and next you are going to find out the again the second largest element, and you are going to place it in the last second place. Okay, so that is how the bubble sort works. Means what? You are trying to find the largest element to place it at its last position. From last you are going to sort. Okay, so now what happens here? First, what we are going to do, we are going to start with the first element. 5 is compared with 1. Okay, is 5 greater than 1? Yes, so it got swapped, you can see here. Okay, now again next element, 5, 4, is it greater? Again swap. Okay, is 5 greater than 2? Yes, so swapping. So now is 5 greater than 8? No, it we are not swapping there. Okay, so at last what happens, after one step, the whatever the greatest element is there, it will get settled in the last position. Okay, so now again what you will do, you are not going to consider this 8 element because it is already in its place. Okay, if you want, you can just check whether to compare while what is the tracing, but there is no need. Okay, so now 1, 4, no swap. 4, 2, yes, you should swap. Yes, it is swap. 4, 5, no need to swap. So you can see here last two elements have been in their position. Next, obviously everything is in the perfect position, so no need to again compare, but still the compiler will do that. Okay, so how we will do this? Can you see here, I told that after this first iteration it left out the last one, then after one more iteration it will not do last two elements, then again after one more iteration last three elements. Like this it is going to neglect the last elements of the step by step. Okay, how? Now we'll go with the program tracing. Okay, as usual, stdio.h, standardlibrary.h, n is the size of the array, a is the array name, and you have some 100 elements to store. I is for main loop. Okay, this first pass, second pass, whatever I told. So that is for this, what is that, I. Okay, again in first pass you have subtopics, right? See, sub steps you have, right? So that is for j. Okay, I is for main thing, j is for the sub. Okay, next, temp. Why we need this temp? Since we are swapping, right? So swapping means we need temp. Okay, so how does this temp works? Consider you are having a coffee cups. Okay, so here in this you have a coffee and here you have a tea. I want to exchange these cups. So what I'll do means what? Not the cups actually, you want to exchange the drinks, whatever is there, into each other cups. So you can't directly mix, right? So what you are going to do, you are going to take the help of one more cup. So if this is A and B, this is then an extra cup. Okay, so that extra cup is called as temp. Temp means temporary. Until I swap this, I need. After that, I don't need. Okay, so let me give you one example for swapping. Consider I have A value as 5, B value as 10. Okay, how to write the swapping? First, I'll write as temp equal to A. Means what? A value will be transferred into temp. Next step, what I'll write, A equal to B. So what happened here? from B, you got the value to the A. So the 10 is transferred here. So now what happened? First A was having 5 and B was having 10. Now A is having 10. So B should have what? 5. Where 5 is stored? In the 10. So I'll give here B equal to 10. So the 5 will be transferred here. So like this you are going to swap the elements. Okay. So now enter the size of the array. I'll give it as 5 and array name is 5 and array is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So next is enter the elements of the array. So as usual it will go for loop. It starts with 0. Yes, 0 is less than 5. So my first element is 5, second element is 1, third element is 4, 2 and 8. Okay, like this you are going to enter the elements which we already discussed how it will be stored. Okay. So now after you enter the elements, it looks like this. Okay, you have the n value and you have the array elements ready. Now let us go with the logic. Okay, so first what is there? I equal to 0. Yes, I have mentioned here I equal to 0. Sorry, by mistake it is I equal to equal to. Okay, it is actually I equal to 0. I is less than n. What is the n value? 5. So I have mentioned here as less than 5. Okay, so it entered this loop. Now for j equal to 0, yes, I have given j is less than n minus I minus 1. Why this n minus I minus 1? Means after each step you are going to neglect the one element, right? So that's why we have there minus I minus 1. Okay, minus I is because we are going to neglect the one element extra. Minus 1, why? When you compare the n element with n minus, n plus 1, if you are going to compare, consider this array is present here only. Let us take this example. If you compare this third element with fourth element, is there any other elements to compare the fourth element with? No, right? So that's why here we have minus 1. Okay, so next, what is there? I have taken here values a of j. What is the j value? We have 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. A of 0, what is their value? 5. A of 1, 1. Is 5 greater than 1? Yes, true. So you are going to swap these two elements. How? By entering into the if loop. Okay. So now, as usual, A of j and A of j plus 1 will be swapped. Okay. In A of j, you have 5 and in A of j plus 1, you have 1. Okay. How it will get swapped? 2mp equal to A of j. First 5 will get here. Then A of j equal to A of j plus 1. So, you will get 1 here. So, obviously, what will be the next step? Transfer the temp value, that is 5. So, this will become 1 and this will become 5. You can see here, it has been swapped 1 and 5. Now, next time what it happens? It won't go for for loop. It will go just for the j loop. It will become 1. Is 1 less than 4? Yes, true. What is there in A of 1? We have 5. And what is there in A of 2? We have 4. Is 5 greater than 4? Yes, true. So again you are going to swap those. Okay, you can see here after swapping it became 1 4 5. Okay, so the next time ij value becomes 2. Again, is 5 greater than 2? Yes, it is true. So again you are going to swap that and you are going to get 2 and 5 in its position. Okay, next j will become 3. Is 3 less than 4? Yes, true. You can see here A of 3 na leni there 5. And in A of 4 you have 8. Is 5 greater than 8? No, right? False. So it will not swap. Means what? If this if condition becomes false, it doesn't enter into this particular loop. Okay. Now, in first step what we did? We compared 5 and 1. In second step, 1, 2. Third step, 2, 3. Fourth step, 3, 4. Okay. Finally, we got this particular array. So the meaning is after we completed the first part, whichever the greatest element is there, that is present in its last position itself. Okay, so that is the meaning. Now for the next one, j will become 4. J is not less than 4. So what happens? This loop will become false. So it will go back for the I loop. Okay, now I will get incremented from 0 to it will become 1. So once it goes back and if it comes inside, the j will again start from 0. Okay, now you can see here j again it started from 0, I is now 1. So now we are going to compare 1 and 4. Is 1 greater than 4? No, right? False. So there is no swap. Now j will become 1. What is there in 1? 4. Is 4 greater than 2? Yes, it is true. So you are going to swap that. After swapping it will look like this. Now j becomes 2. Is 2 less than 3? Yes, correct. Now, is 4 greater than 5? No, it is false. So, there is no swapping at all. You can see here, already the elements are in the perfect order. So, it will not swap even if the elements improve. Okay. But let us trace it off. Okay. So, now J value is 3, right? Now, 3 is not less than 3. So, it is false. It will go back for I. So, 1 will become what? 2. Now, the J will start from 0 again. Okay. So, now is 1 greater... J will start from 0. Is 1 greater than 2? No, false. Now, in the next step. In the next step, is 2 greater than 4? No, false. Again, J will become 2. Is 2 less than 2? No. So, this J loop is false. So, again, it will go back for the I. So, now 2 will become what? 3. Okay. So, now when it becomes 3, when it again enters into the J loop, it will start from 0. So, we are going to obviously compare 0 with next element. That's why we have here A of J is greater than A of J plus 1. Okay. J means 0. So, A of 0. J plus 1 means 0 plus 1 is 1. A of 0 na leni the value 1. A of 1 na leni the 2. So, is 1 greater than 2? No, it is false. Okay. So, now the next step is J will become 1. Is 1 less than 1? No, it is false. So, again it will go for I. So, I will become now 4. You can see here. Again, J will become 0. Is 0 less than 0? No, it is false, right? So, again, it will go for I and I will become 5. So, when I becomes 5, is 5 less than 5? No, false. So, at last, what it does? It will print the sorted array. So, for I equal to 0 until I is less than 5, whatever the elements have been sorted, you are going to get. So, this is called as bubble sort. If you have any doubts, please feel free to contact me. Already, I have explained this program by tracing. So, I went a bit fast. Hope you understood this. Okay. Thank you, students.